Levar Green.
Commander Melissa Gardner.
When I first found out I had COVID-19, one of the major symptoms I had was I was very, very fatigued. One of the other things is my appetite went away. I couldn't eat anything. My sense of smell went away after about the fourth day. My energy levels were just so low that I tried to do a little exercise as far as body weight push-ups. I couldn't do 5 push-ups. So losing 10 pounds in 7 days was, you know, it was drastic because I could see it in my face and my neck and everything. So it made a big difference.
Some of the symptoms that I felt early on with the COVID-19 was the coughing, shortness of breath, headaches, and fatigue. And I also had a temperature, not as high as most, but I did carry a fever for a certain period of time.
A couple who both suffered COVID, they went through a very difficult time. I believe the husband was on a vent. And those who are listening who have been on a ventilator, it takes a lot out of you. You might test negative, but you are in no way recovered. And so, you know, atrophy sets in. If you've been bedridden for a month, in some cases, folks have been bedridden for 5 to 6 weeks trying to recover from this disease. So it was important for me, once I was diagnosed with COVID, and like many, I was lethargic, didn't want to move, and pretty much the disease wants you to do that. And I decided I'm not going to do that, I'm going to fight, just like I'm fighting for my life with a suspect in the field.
I had a nurse that was assigned to me from the department, and one of the main things she told me is to make sure you drink a lot of fluids, vitamin C, eat healthy. I had a lot of ginger in my diet, so ginger juice was pretty good as far as me boosting my immune system, but the biggest thing is just what I was putting in my body, and it helped me to recover.
To not allow the virus to defeat me, one of the things that I did is made sure my diet was correct, ate a lot of fruits and vegetables, and really made sure that I was taking in vitamin C.
So this fight was no different. And so I fought staying in the bed. I continued to push myself to move around. And then, against doctor's orders, my daughter in Dallas, Texas, who said, I know what you want to do, you want to work out, but don't do it. You need rest. And the doctor told me, you need to rest. And I did pay attention to that in part. But I also knew what was most important for me is to move. And part of my view of battling this deadly virus was not only to just move around, but for me to get up, get on the stationary bike, and push through it, and fight through it.
I did begin to bike. I am an avid runner. However, due to my lungs being affected, I didn't feel comfortable enough to run, but was able to get on the bike, starting with 15-minute workouts, then to 30 to 40-minute workouts.
First couple of days, I couldn't do a lot. So as far as things to help you boost your immune system and get you going, if you're eating healthy and you're doing a lot of body weight exercises, just small things to start off with, push-ups, sit-ups, even if you just do a small little walk in your house, just walking back and forth throughout the house and things, going up and down the stairs. Small things can kind of help you to boost your immune system, but the main thing I recommend, and a lot of doctors will tell you, is rest.
In the aftermath of COVID, I've increased the rigor of my fitness program because I want to stay strong, and it's starting to work. I mean, I think now where I'm at as of today, I'm probably stronger than pre-COVID because I've been really pushing myself to drive through it. Because we don't know enough about this disease. We don't know that many say, well, you got the antibodies, you'll be fine. But do we know the antibodies are going to work? In closing, I just want to say that, one, I am so proud of each and every one of you. You know, who would have imagined that we would be in this type of fight with this unknown deadly enemy? I certainly had no idea. But the fact that many of you who have been stricken, quarantine, fearful that you too might be hit by this enemy, you continue to go out and serve this community with distinction and honor. And for that, I'm deeply humbled as your leader. I thank you for what you do each and every day. But we're going to get through this together. We must continue to fight in unison. because when we fight the good fight, we will always prevail. Thank you. And in closing, I just say, may God bless each and every one of you, because you are truly doing God's work.